Well, fine, everyone who's watching right now. And today I will show you my Indiana Jones collection, which is logical since I did show you already my Star Wars collection. And the two are connected, obviously, because both were created by George Lucas. George Lucas did not really direct any of Indiana Jones movies, but he was the creator of the basic story. Steven Spielberg was the one who directed all of them. And the first item that I have is the Adventures of Indiana Jones box set. This is the first time when the films were released on DVD, so not on VHS. There was a VHS release of Trilogy already, the first three movies. Nice hard box. Obviously white screen. Full screen edition is different color. It's... I think it's white, not brown. I like brown texture better. It's a complete DVD movie collection and again THX, just like Star Wars, but this is Paramount, not Fox, but still Lucasfilm. Yeah. And then a very good picture of Indy himself. He's played by Harrison Ford, who played Han Solo in Star Wars. And he did, I think he did play somebody in American Graffiti, that's a George Lucas film. Here's the backside, they got the Temple of Doom, the Raiders of the Lost Ark, Last Crusade, and bonus material disc. So you can see Moto Star Wars, there's a separate disc with special materials, but this time as you can see, it's not double box, it's box inside the box, but the box is hard. And let's take a look at them again. Here's the first one. Well, it's the first one chronologically, but it was released second. So people, a lot of people confuse this. They consider it second part, but it's actually first part in time, in terms of the timeline of events. But yeah, it was supposed to by Drew Struzan. And this one my favorite. It's the first that I've seen. Yeah, I've seen it, it is one of the first movies that I saw. So yeah, the darkest and most chilling adventure. Yeah, so I like that. It's the darkest chapter of Indy's adventures. I think it's the best one. Yeah, not really special features on individual disc. Not even commentary tracks. Now. There was released an additional box set, the new one which was released prior to the first film, which did include, I think, commentaries and introductions, but the bonus disc wasn't there, so I recommend getting this set, because, well, for me, I don't really like commentaries, sometimes it's specific for some release, like Cannibal the Musical or From Dusk Till Dawn, that commentary tracks are very good, but, yeah, well... Let's see, the main disc is here, very nice artwork. So, this is the first poster, this is the main poster, but here's the teaser poster that I recreated. And cool tagline, if adventure has a name, it must be Indiana Jones. And then there's scene selections here. Nice. And on the back it's the same, so yeah, I keep scene selections because it's more interesting. Why do I need to just look second time at the cover? So here's the second one chronologically, the Raiders of the Lost Ark, or, well, simply Raiders of the Lost Ark. You know, obviously, that the Star Wars first movie, New Hope, they changed it later and put it New Hope, but here it's still just without Indiana Jones in the actual movie. Now the poster here, it's a combination of two posters that were released for the original movie. This is the back side. They're all quite similar. Yeah. Greatest screen adventure of all time. And I think it's these first two, I think, are the best ones. Again, nice artwork. And yeah, so here's different version. So this version of indie was with this background here, and the opposite. This version was with this background. Yeah, The Return of the Great Adventure. Yeah, I guess it's more suitable to say that it's a sequel to Temple of Doom, but again, it was released before Temple of Doom, so what does it mean? Well, I guess an homage on old 30s, 50s adventure movies that Lucas and Spielberg grew up in. And here's the third one, The Last Crusade. Yeah, kind of a good arc, all by Drew Struzan, a frequent collaborator of Spielberg and Lucas. Now, this one is my least favorite in the series so far, because I think it's basically very similar to the Raiders. Because, yeah, again, Nazis, again, religious artifact, and yeah, a lot of people like Boston as the best ones and don't like Temple, and I guess because it's different, same like with Halloween 3, I like Halloween 3, I think it's much better than what came after. So yeah, I kind of don't really like Last Crusade because it's too repetitive. But on its own, it's a fine movie. Just doesn't work as a sequel, same as Ghostbusters 2, also too repetitive. But yeah, standard good artwork. And yeah, the way that happened with this one, you see, this is the first edition of poster. This was a teaser poster. However, this, like, the surroundings that you see the border, it was used for this one. However, the sun was used for this one. Yeah, I know, it's confusing, but the tagline's two here now. Have the adventure of your life, keep up with Joneses, and the man with the hat is back, and this time he's bringing his dad. And the bonus material disc. I believe Drew Struzan did draw this special artwork, because he keeps drawing artwork for different posters still. Not very used frequently anymore, now it's all digital, but it might be inspired, like Avengers posters, they are inspired by his artwork. Okay, here's some behind the scenes photos and very nice description. Yeah, so here's actually say how long everything in. It's 3 hours and 7 minutes. Disc and see. Yeah, again, same, so I just keep it like this. And yeah, I don't know. This is, I guess, the basic one, just like with Star Wars, Empire of Dreams was the main feature here. Making the trilogy is the main feature. Oh, come on, why is it the same? But we also do have same Star Wars additional Light and Magic of Indiana Jones, the sound of Indiana Jones, the stance of Indiana Jones, the music of Indiana Jones, original trailers, and exclusive DVD-ROM content, basically the website, which probably doesn't work, it might still work, yeah. But we are done with these things. So yeah, a very cool box set. There is a Blu-ray edition that includes all movies, but the way they did it, it includes bits and pieces of this disc, and it does include commentaries, maybe introductions, yeah, I'm not sure, but I know that not everything from this disc is included on Blu-ray. It doesn't add some new ones, exclusive to Blu-ray, but yeah, you, same as Star Wars, if you want, you need to get at least these discs separately. And the last one is Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, the 2-disc special edition on Blu-ray. They did a DVD version, the 2-disc, they did standard DVD release, and they did a special edition DVD also. Yeah. As you can see, it's Kind of not very Struzan. The main poster is Drew Struzan. He did draw it, but this is an alternate, but it's still fine, I think. Very like this yellow ribbons around. Yeah, a non-stop thrill ride. Yeah, I think it's okay, this movie. People don't like it, but again, it's different for me. So I like it more than Last Crusade, at least because it tries to be different. Yeah, on disc two we have pre-production featurette, Indiana Jones Timelines. I think it's exclusive to Blu-ray, that's only details from Blu-ray, and the return of alleged featurette and trailers. On disc two we have Production Diary, Making Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, Warrior Makeup, The Crystal Skulls, yeah, Iconic Props, and Venture in Post-Production, The Effects of Indie, Closing Team Indie, Previsualization Sequences, Galleries, Production Photographs, Portraits, Behind the Scenes Photographs. And they're all in HD except of galleries, yeah, they are not in HD. Because not all the times that I noticed that everything is in HD on Blu-ray releases. But here is a. I checked same artwork on DVD edition, and I guess it's also same artwork. Special features disc. Very nice, I think. This is from the time when Blu-rays were cool. I think it's from. I divided on the first period of Blu-ray, second and third. First one was kind of bad. Third one is not so bad, and the second one is the best one. So yeah, I think it's quite a nice addition to fun adventure movies. By the time of this video, there's no fifth movie. It said that it's in works, but who knows? I hope it will be released and it will be different again. But that's it for this video. See you soon.